Everybody, welcome to day 47 of the lockdown. It's Saturday, so it's just half day today. Been making a few little textured kiln fillers, little sort of Winobi type things. So I've been throwing those and having a bit of fun. Okay, here it is. Mentioned this before, but I throw this part with a dry finger and it drags in the base there and it compresses it. And if you're watching these, a lot of these, you hear me say the same thing over and over again, but it does well to repeat what I'm trying to do. Not everybody watches every video. I think that'd be purgatory, to be honest with you, watching all my videos. I don't think I could do it. I certainly couldn't do it. But try again. Try slightly different. Rib. That's a bit better, isn't it? If at first you don't succeed. Okay, I'm going to try a slightly different one here before I crack on and finish the rest off camera. This one's going to have a wiggly wire, so I need to make it even thicker walled. So it cuts deeper. This is a spiral wire. You've seen me use it before. It's not actually cutting that much away, it's just making an indentation. All these bits will drop off when it dries. weird and wonderful, isn't it? Just smooth the edge, because people will be wanting to drink out of this. Hopefully. I like my pots to be used rather than just sort of collected. It's nice. Nothing wrong with collecting pots. I've got a few, though I do use most of them. I'm just having a slightly different idea here. I'm just going to make it a little bit more bowl shaped to begin with before I start decorating the surface. And I'm just going to do it in four places, rather than all the way around. I'm going to leave a gap, so I'll do opposites. That makes it easier. I like this idea of sort of creating on the wheel. It's fun. If you're a beginner, when you've built up the skills a little bit, it's quite nice to get to that point where you can sort of experiment. And I'm just going to use this, my favourite rib. I couldn't get it into the vertical one, so what I'm going to do is just use it to flare this out into a bowl shape. See what's happening there? Split up. Anyway, you get the idea. Went a bit too far with that one. Oh well. You don't get anywhere without a few failures. Know your limits, find out what they are, push it to the limit and then come back to it. Try again.
Okay, that's day 47 sorted. Today's book is A Cup of Sake Beneath the Cherry Tree. And it's written by Buddhist monk Yoshida Kenko, and it says it's a set of random observations and thoughts regarding random things. So he's just put his thoughts down, written them down. And a quote from it is, "It's a most wonderful comfort to sit alone beneath a lamp, books spread before you, and commune with someone from the past that you have never met." It just sums up reading a book, doesn't it, really? There you go. See you tomorrow.